Technology Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about blood flow measurement trainer kit. So in this video, we are going to discuss about its working, its body parts, its calculation and its application. So the main application of this apparatus is we can use it to measure the velocity of flowing blood.
Now let's talk about the body parts of this kit. So this is the main switch. This is the 5-pin socket. Here transducer is connected. This is the audio controller. This is the headphone jack. These are the output ports. And this is the LED indication which indicates the system is on. And these are the LED lights which shows the audio range. And this is the gel which is provided in the kit. And this is the DSO. Now let's talk about the working of this kit. So first of all, we will connect this transducer to the kit, then we will connect this headphones to the kit, then there are two patch cords which we will use to connect the DSO to this kit. So the black color patch cord is connected to the black wire of the DSO and the red one is connected to the other wire of the DSO like this. Then we will switch on the apparatus from this button. So now our apparatus is ready to work. Now we will switch on the DSO also. So now we will measure the blood flow. So for that we will apply this gel on our hand. Like this, then we will take the transducer and we will put it on our hand. And here we can see that on the DSO there is a movement which shows the blood flow measurement. And you can hear the sound through these headphones. And you can increase the audio from here. So here on the DSO screen you can see that the signal or the waves are propagating. So this shows that the blood flow of our body. So if you want to get better signal at the output on the DSO, then you should keep the audio at around 7 or 8 and put the transducer on your hand like this. And move like this. So here you can see that on the DSO the signals are more good and you can hear the audio on the headphone also. So that is how you can get more good waveforms on the DSO.
So some of the points you should keep in mind while performing this experiment is you should keep the DSO on storage mode, and here is the storage button. You should press it before starting the experiment. Then you should keep the voltage at 0.5 volt. From here you can control the voltage and you will see the voltage here. So these are the points you should keep in mind.
Now let's talk about the calculation part. So first of all we will calculate F1, that is apparent frequency. So F1 is equal to F into in bracket C minus V cos theta upon C. So here F1 is apparent frequency, F is transmitted frequency, C is velocity of sound in blood, theta is the angle of inclination of the incident wave to the direction of blood flow, V is the velocity of blood cells. So that is how you can calculate F1. So after calculating F1, we can calculate F2. That is F2 is equal to F1 into C upon C plus V cos theta. Then we can calculate Doppler shift. That is del F is equal to F minus F2. Then we can calculate Doppler shift del F. After that we will calculate V. V is equal to C into del F upon 2 into F cos theta. And that is how we can calculate the velocity. Now let's see the block diagram. So this is the block diagram of blood flow meter. You can see it on the manual also.
So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.